गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आज सबसे पहले ऑन 25 दिसंबर आई से यू मैरी क्रिसमस। दिस इज द एंड ऑफ वन ईयर एंड स्टार्ट ऑफ न्यू ईयर। इन दिस फेस्टिव सीजन I will tell you about how to write research, seminar, summer training and project reports. जैसा कि मुझे अपने experience से पता चला, बहुत सारे students से interaction करने के बाद, कि students करना तो चाहते हैं प्रोजेक्ट वर्क, रिसर्च वर्क, समर ट्रेनिंग, उनके मन में एक शंका होती है, संशय होता है। वो संशय ये होता है कि हम प्रोजेक्ट कैसे चुने, हम कैसे उसकी रिपोर्ट बना दें। जैसे ही हम उनसे कहते हैं कि आप एक प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट लिखो, तो उनके दिमाग में ये आता है, पहला जो विचार आता है वो ये आता है कि रिपोर्ट का मतलब है कि हम कंप्लीट प्रोजेक्ट बना के उसकी रिपोर्ट लिखें, जबकि ऐसा नहीं है। रिपोर्ट, द लिटरल मीनिंग ऑफ रिपोर्ट, व्हाट इज द रिपोर्ट, वी रिपोर्टिंग समथिंग। तो आज का जो मेरा ये लेक्चर है, वो लेक्चर है सभी प्रोफेशनल स्टूडेंट्स के लिए, इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स, मेडिकल स्टूडेंट्स और जितने भी स्टूडेंट्स जो इंटर्नशिप करते हैं। मैं इसमें एक चीज भूल गया, इंटर्नशिप आल्सो फॉर इंटर्नशिप आल्सो यू कैन राइट द रिपोर्ट फॉर इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट आल्सो। You can write the industrial visit also. For industrial visit, you can write the report also. But what is the structure of any report? What is the structure of any report? Now we discuss structure of a report. First of all, I am describe you the mini project or summer mini project if you want to write down a project report. This report is for mini project also. This report may be for major project also. Or any type of project. First of all, you have to write introduction. So, first point is introduction. So what you have to write in this introduction part, suppose you want to develop a project in image processing. Suppose you have an idea to write a project, to develop a project in image processing. So in introduction part, you must know what is your specific idea in image processing. So you must go through the literature for the areas of applications like face recognition, medical, you can also do the civil, criminal, and so on. Once you go through the this image processing, face, medical, all other application areas, you must go through the first of all, what is image processing? Then, what is image processing? What are the main application areas? See, what is the motivation for selecting specific topic? Suppose you have selected the medical area. So now you must write the motivation for this area. You can say that nowadays we have lot of images from CT scan, from X-ray, and from MRI scanning. We have lot of medical images. If one want to discuss with the other another doctor, तो वो उन images को उस doctor के पास भेजने से पहले अगर हम उसका analysis कर लें और उस analysis को अगर हम भेजते हैं जल्दी से जल्दी, तो वो डॉक्टर ज्यादा अच्छा सजेशन दे पाएगा. अब मोटिवेशन के बाद आपको अपना ये पता होना चाहिए व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड मोटिवेशन. मोटिवेशन, हु मोटिवेट्स अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट, अबाउट दिस work, and objective, what will be you think, what is will be the outcome of this project. So objective must be clear, what do you want to do, because you are writing the report for a project. So you have done some homework before writing the project. What? Go through similar type of work. Then you will get motivation, and then you decide objective. So this can be done before writing the introduction. When you complete the introduction part, so introduction, what is the introduction? So in summary, introduction consists of brief detail about the field you have chosen. Second, the motivation. Here also you have done on the application areas, real world, to show the impact of your research, of your project, of your idea, of your summer training. And after that you have defined your objective. This objective is not like that you have done work and you are writing the objective. Objective is that your thought. What do you want to do? It may be possible that you have write down the objective, broad objective, and you have done there are three or four things, but you have completed only one thing, then it will be the objective at the last. So the main objective will be defined after your project, but you can decide what is your objective to doing this research or doing this report, this project or summer training. So the introduction part, before introduction part, because you go through all the literature which provides you the brief detail about the field of your chosen, application of areas of this field, motivation for your work, and the objective. You find that this is my objective, I want to do, because after reading the literature you come through the lot of papers, a lot of projects, you find out the objective. So objective must be the, you must contain some newer things, some new things means you want, there are two things, you are giving your idea which is new, or you are adding something existing concept. You can say that we are doing some comparative analysis. Comparative analysis was also a project. If you are doing some comparative analysis of previous works, this is also comes into the projects. So for engineering students, for undergraduate students, and now my focus is undergraduate students, that is B.Tech students, BSc students, medical students, to find out the projects. So in the introduction part, you have to write down brief detail about the field because you go through the literature and the application areas of that topic. Then you find the motivation for your work. If you don't go through the literature, then how you can find out the motivation? Maybe the Santa Claus comes in your dream and then say that this is your work. No, you have to go through the literature. So this is the all about the introduction. Now we discuss what is the next. Next is the what? This is the introduction part. You go through the introduction part. Next part is literature review. This is the most important part of any project, of any summer training, of any internship. You have done some project, you must go to the literature. In literature review, what you have to do? You have to go through the, when you have defined the objective. So your objective defines what type of literature you need. Generally what happens, to get information about the field. So field basic concept of your topic, basic concepts. So basic concepts consists of the research papers or projects or knowledge about your field. So you can go through the basic. Then we have decided some, in objective we have subdivided the particular application area. Particular application area. So this application area gives you the another papers, another projects which are related to your application area, because field consists of lot of application areas. You have specified in objective, you have to specify your application area, because in image processing you have specific area, that is medical image analysis. So you go through the research papers, projects, that what type of image analysis is encompassing in the medical areas. When you go through the literature review, you can categorize your review. You can categorize your review in a category. First category, that is the introduction about field. Second category, that some are doing in one direction. Second one is second direction. You have to go through the all the directions, all the methodologies. Adapted in previous work. So it may be the literature review or previous work, or maybe you can say related work. So once you go through the literature review, related work, previous works in your specific objective, specific area which you define in the objective, you find out two things. What are the two things you have find out? You will find out what they have did in their work. Second, drawbacks or shortcomings or limitations. And from these limitations, limitations and future scope, you have to find out new things, new, as we have defined, what are you new or novice idea, as we defined in the introduction part. So what do you have doing new thing? So how to find out the new thing? If you don't find out the new thing, then what is the motive behind doing the any project? Because your project must have some novice idea, novice things. It may be a single point, or it may be a single thing you have added to the previous idea, then it is the novel idea. So novice idea, or we can say novel idea. So the purpose of literature review is find out new things to be implemented. So for each research paper, you have find out these things, the what they have did in their work, drawbacks on shortcomings or limitations of the their work, and from the limitations and future scope, you have to go through the new or novice idea. So from lot of papers you have discussed, suppose you have done 15 papers or ideas or projects, similar projects type of things, so related work, and you find out what are the new things you can add to the previous work. So suppose in our example, if processing is done on CT scan and you find that there is no image analysis is done on MRI scan, so you can think, see that you can find out that we can add the MRI scanning also. From the MRI scanning, the results must be improved. So this is your new one. You can find out that analysis can be done on the number of images or data analysis. New approach to data analysis you can add. If we can use this image in this way, then we can find out, we can easily diagnose the disease. So till now, what we have? Introduction, what we have? Introduction. In introduction, we have brief detail about field and the application areas and motivation and objective. So because of this motivation and objective and the application area you have decided, you link your next section, which is called literature review. In literature review, one thing must be clear. If you want to write any summer training or project report or any report, it must be a connection between previous and next section. Because, for example, in introduction and literature review, we have connected these two sections by the motivation and objective. In objective, we want to do this thing. So you have the well connected sections. In literature review, you are finding out gaps in previous work, research, and project. So, in literature review, what you have done? Gaps in previous work, research, or project. So, we have connected these two concepts. Now, what will be the outcome of this? You can say that literature review. You find out the gaps, and these gaps provide you the third point of your report, that is called introduction, literature review, and third point, you have find out that a problem statement. ज़्यादातर जो students हैं, जो जितना भी मेरा experience है, जितने मेरे students हैं, last 15 years, I've gone through the different students. So, what is the motivation for this video? The problems arises from the students, problem asked by the student, that how we find out the problem. So how you find out the problem in the problem statement, that your project title also related to your problem statement. What is your problem statement? That is also your project title also. So title can be defined after the whole report. So what is the problem statements? In problem statement, you find out in literature review gaps. You find out in literature review. In literature review, you find out the gaps. And in these gaps, maybe suppose 1 to 10 gaps. You can select only all 10 gaps or any one gap that you can fill. So on the basis of these gaps, how this literature review and problem statement are connected? In the literature review, find out the gaps, and on the basis of these gaps you are stating your statement. Suppose there are 10 gaps you have find out. You have find out 10 gaps. You can select 1, 2, 3 or all the gaps to complete, to add, to fill these gaps to the previous work. So that is your problem statement. So what is the gaps? Because these gaps are existing. So this is your novice idea or novel thing. When I ask the students what is your new in this your project, so they see their face here and there. So from this you find out the noble things. And the because you go through the literature review, you go through the research papers, you go through the previous projects. So now you have the confidence to say that, sir, this is our noble things. When you find out the new things, so your problem statement is valid. So one research paper can be done on problem statement and one in literature review, survey. Survey paper and problem statement paper. There are two research papers you can publish on this topic, on this work, from this work. After that, you have gone through the introduction and you gone through the literature review. Then you gone through the problem statement. So this is not the right way. This is not the right way to write the problem abruptly. No. You have to go through the literature review, then you find the gaps, then you find the gaps. On these gaps, you find your problem statement. And how you go to the literature review, then your objective will define in which direction you want to the literature review. So objective connects the literature review. Literature review gaps connected to the problem statement. Now this will define your project title. In 7th semester, 8th semester, especially for AKTU students, अभी जो project 7th semester का है वो 200 marks का हो गया है, और जो आपका 8th semester में जो project है वो 600 marks का हो गया है. So, उसकी report हमें चाहिए होती है. उस report के लिए आपको अपना title देने से पहले आपको इतना काम करना होगा. You have to do this work. आपको इतना काम करके ही अपना प्रोजेक्ट टाइटल अब आप इजीली डिफेंड कर सकते हो कि सर मैं ये काम क्यों कर रहा हूं. ज्यादातर बच्चे डिफेंड नहीं कर पाते हैं कि हम ये काम क्यों कर रहे हैं. यू कैन डिफेंड नाउ. सो नाउ यू कैन डिफेंड योर प्रोजेक्ट टाइटल. आफ्टर दैट योर वर्क्स स्टार्ट. स्टूडेंट्स थिंक्स दैट if we ask the project report, they said that we have completed and this is a running project. No, this is not the way. You have to give the project title based on these 3 points. So these 3 points constitutes your project title. Before giving the project title, you go through these 3 steps. So I think till now you have full knowledge about how we give the project title. How we give the problem statement on the basis of literature review. And in literature review, what is your objective? Objective is defined from the application area of the field you have chosen. So, now you can take break and think over it. This is your all the project title. You cannot abruptly say that this is my topic, sir. No, you must go through these 3 topics. Now, this is the A part. A part of your project, of your training, of your summer training. So, A part consists of what? Introduction, literature review, and problem statement. And after the problem, you can find out the title of your work. Now, second part of a project starts. This consists of what? Methodology. Of your research or flowchart of your work and then work. Implemented. After that, the new part of your is coming from B. So we will discuss this in the next video, in the companion video. Okay, I will post this video after some time. We can go through that. Thank you. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can contact me. FB Dr. RK Baghel 2020@gmail.com. On this mail ID. On this mail ID. FB Dr. RK Baghel. You can contact me on this email ID FB Dr. RK Baghel 2020@gmail.com. You can send me query. On this. Thanks.